give me a four. So which means that everyone here had been here before. So, but let me quickly introduce this community to you. This is a community of wealthy people, people that we are helping to build wealth from scratch and to attain wealth in 5 years. And what we say is that in 2 years on the medium term and 5 years on the long term, you'll be able to say, by the grace of God, I can never be poor again. And this is what I say. I've always known that without a mentor in life, you are left to the limit of your struggles. Two Saturdays ago, I defined mentor, a mentor as men who have poured a path and they have made a success at it. And you need to tour the same path. You just ride on their wings to cross the path rather than turning the path. Ladies and gentlemen, I've always known that without a mentor in life, you are left to the limit of your struggles. But with a mentor, you have a wing to fly. That's why I've therefore lived my life trying to mentor young and sometimes older people in various aspects of life. The result of this mentorship is a growing community of mentees with unbelievable results. I saw this from Craig Mapp, who said, if you can film an idea, if you can film yourself as a wealthy man, as a wealthy woman, if you can film an idea in your mind, and you do not stop at filming that idea, you begin to follow that idea, shot for shot, scene for scene, you are sure going to achieve that which you have shot in your mind. That is why what we see is a community of 10,000 wealthy people in the year 2025. If you want to be part of those 10,000, can you just give me a 6 in the chat box? You want to be a part of the community of 10,000 people that we are building and that in 2025 will be proud to say anything I want in life, I can afford it. You can be proud to say, by the grace of God, I cannot be poor again. If you are one of those people that want to be among those 10,000, please give me a 6 in the chat box. If you are giving me a 6 or you are about to give me a 6, and you are not yet a member of the community, let you know that attending seminars every Saturday and Sunday does not make you a member of the community. You are going now on Saturday, where we reframe your mindset, where we teach you discipline, where we teach you accountability and how the wealthy people think, the skills that the wealthy people have, the lifestyle, traditional lifestyle of a wealthy man, a wealthy woman. And Sunday, we come to show you products and opportunities that wealthy people take advantage of to enter into their wealth. Then, having considered all of these, you might decide, I want to be a member of this community, not on a part-time attending seminars, but I want to be a member. I want to go beyond the learning. I want to go beyond that is showcased in this community. Yes, and that, then you can join our corrupt league. From February, we are tightening the admission process. From February, if you want to join this community, you apply through an electronic form will be circulated instead of the admission link straight. The electronic form will be circulated and you fill it and the committee will process it. When it is processed and you are favorably considered, then the moment you see yourself on that platform, then you are a member of that community and your application has been accepted. You can be informed and not updated. That is the reason why what you know yesterday is good. But every opportunity to know additional things, please embrace it. Don't be too busy doing what gives you 20% result in life. Face the things that gives you 80% result in life and let those things propel you into wealth and into greatness. Profit is what you earn when is what you get when your money works for you. Don't forget that. And let me just give you one of the testimonials of some members of the community. Femi John said, I followed financial mentoring with Yemi Ayodele in his several meetings and programs. And I have always learned business concepts really well from the way he explained things. I also find it easy to internalize what he's saying in each program. Sometimes I listen to him even while I'm at work. It's been great being around him and the community to be sharing high quality content and making it so easily accessible. Let's read one more testimonial. Of David R. He said, I have been a member of the mentorship training with Yemi Adele for over 2 months. That was about 2 months ago. And he has many areas of my life is experiencing a paradigm shift. This program has shaped my financial life for the better, making earning in 7 digits in a week a reality. One of the things we teach you as a member of the community is to stop depending on your salary. Continue to earn your salary for as long as you feel comfortable earning your salary. But please, one of the things we teach you is never to depend on your salary. So that is why if you join the community, the first point we start with is that 50% of your income, daily, weekly, monthly, comes to the community for investment on your behalf. And so, and after 6 months, we grow you into donating 80% of your income into the community for yourself, not for the community. But you are guided on how to invest it, and the result in 2 years is going to be very, very massive. Ladies and gentlemen, that is just on the way of introduction. If you have not yet followed, shared our postings on our different social media, please locate on Facebook, on Instagram, Wealth Card Mentor. And you can follow, like, and share content every single day. There are content. Every single day, there are content posted on this platform, ladies and gentlemen. So if you want to join, please find Wealth Card Mentor on Facebook, on Instagram, and on Twitter, and join and follow this platform. Oh, sorry about that. I said today's topic is the skills that you need to acquire on your journey to wealth. What are the skills that I need? What are the skills that wealthy people possess as they journey to wealth? Ladies and gentlemen, it's very important. Every terrain requires its skill. If you want to be a mechanic, you need skill. If you want to be a contractor, you need skill. If you want to be an engineer, you need skill. Ladies and gentlemen, if you want to be wealthy, there are some skills that are specific to that terrain. And that's what two last week, and I'm just going to brief us. We said one of the skills that you need in your journey to wealth is persuasion skill. Persuasion skill. And we define persuasion. Sorry, we keep having this fluctuation. You must be a man of integrity. You must be a person of sincerity in your journey to wealth. If you must succeed in your journey to wealth, you must have the persuasion skill. But to do well in persuasion, you need integrity. You need sincerity. People will never believe you the moment you lose your integrity. The moment they discover that you are not a sincere person, they will never believe you. You can't persuade them even to greet them good morning. They will start greeting. They will need to check whether it's actually morning or evening when you greet them. Why? Because you have lost your integrity. If you want to be a
I think the coach has a network issue. Please, if you can hear me, can you type a 2 in the chat box? If you can hear me, please chat a 2 in the chat box. Okay, thank you. Thank you very much. I think the coach has a network issue. And I think he was trying to summarize what we did last week. I think that was what he was trying to do, talking about persuasion. I was talking about persuasion, and for you to have the power of persuasion, you must be a person of integrity, a person of integrity. And also you must have a character or attitude of being influential. You must have influence, because a person with persuasion comes with the power of influence. Persuasion and influence comes together. Persuasion and influence. A persuasive person is an influential person. That means the person can make people believe in them and make them do what they want them to do, even if they don't want to do it. Even if they don't want to do it. Please, if you can still hear me, let me have a 3 in the chat box, please. If you can still hear me, let me have a 3. Okay, welcome back, coach.
Thank you. Sorry, I've been having some challenges here. I don't know why. I'm trying to get back on my main device where I can show the slides. Just be patient with me. So we're talking about the skill of persuasion. Don't forget, this skill rides on 2 things, sincerity and integrity. You will not be able to persuade anyone if you are not a sincere person. And that is why if there is anything you must protect as a wealthy man or as a man on a journey to wealth, you must protect your sincerity. You must ensure that nothing tampers with your sincerity. You must protect your integrity. When these two things are in place, it becomes very easy for you to convince someone to make people do what you want them to do, even if they didn't want to do it before you stepped on stage. So it's very important. The second skill that we spoke about yesterday, on last week Saturday, is energy management skill. Energy management skill. And you ask yourself, why energy management skill? What's so important about managing energy? Ladies and gentlemen, it's very, very, to a wealthy man, his energy is one of his strengths. His ability to also manage that energy is a skill that he must take. And so, and I said, watch the games and sports of wealthy people. Last week, we looked at some games and sports where you find wealthy people. And we said, we listed them as what? You can list them for me again. Chess, Scrabble, golf. Just see some people just using some very expensive rods and pushing some balls inside inside a ditch. And to them, they are doing some, thank you, Olusegun, Monopoly. Sorry. Sorry, I don't know why network is so bad today. So permit me to just continue here, and but you may not be able to see my slide. So I said that when you look at the sports of wealthy people, we started listing them: chess, Monopoly, Scrabble, darts, all of that. And so when you look at it, you can see a rich man playing or having boxing as a sport. You can see a rich man, or someone can become rich through some of those sports that are laborious. But you never see a made wealthy man doing boxing. You never see him doing wrestling. You will not even see a wealthy man doing football. You know why? Because they understand the power of energy management. They don't appear everywhere. They don't appear in every occasions. They don't appear in every invitations. They conserve their energy. Don't forget, they conserve their energy for the 20% activities that gives them 80% of their results. Do you understand that? They conserve their energy to the 20% activities that gives them 80% of their result. Ladies and gentlemen, let's continue from where we stopped last week, and let's talk about some other skills that you need to learn on your journey to wealth. Number three is aggressive patience skill. If wealthy people are aggressively patient, you will say, how? Let me tell you, wealthy people are aggressively patient. And you must understand, wealthy people understand that success takes time. Poor people want results as soon as they start. And that's why you see a poor person, they open shops every year and close it. Why? Because they just think that the results should come in 1 year. So the moment after the first rent, they have not succeeded, they pack off. Let me tell you, anytime a wealthy man is planning a business, let me tell you some things which are applied severally in different businesses that I've run. Number one, when a wealthy man is starting a business, he already makes provision for between 6 months and 1 year salary of his employees. Is part of his plan. What does that tell me? In case I am not able to make profits or even make sales in the next 6 months, in the next 1 year, I am ready. I am prepared. I have understood the wealth making process to that point that you know that money don't just come just like that. Success takes time. Wealthy people understand that this very importantly and very well, that success takes time. They understand that if you stick to it, you will get it. If you stick to it, you will get it. That is why they seem to have grown their patience skill aggressively. So they are aggressively patient. Wealthy people are aggressively patient. Ladies and gentlemen, let me tell you, if you're on your journey to wealth and you are not patient, you know, you will see some investment opportunity. They will call you. They will say, this one, you have to keep your money for 20 months. You say, what if I need the money? What if you didn't get the money? What if they stole the money from you? The money you think you need tomorrow. What if they stole it from you? Somebody say, you are not hearing me. If you are hearing me, please give me a 3 in the chat box. If you are hearing me, please give me a 3 in the chat box. Okay, so please, Oluwatosin, please find your bottom left. Go to your bottom left. You will see a microphone. Just click it and choose connect call over internet. That should solve the challenge that you are having. That should solve it. I don't know if that's exactly what it is, but it should solve it. Now, what was I saying? Wealthy people understand that success takes time. Like I said, the analogy I was given, if you are building a business, prepare for your 6 months to 1 year salary of your staff. You sometimes it is possible, depending on the size of the business, prepare for the next rent on the business property. Why do you think that when banks give big loans, they have what we call a moratorium period. Moratorium period. M-O-R-I-R-A-T-O-R-I-U-M. They have what we call a moratorium period. What is a moratorium period? It's a bank which, because of the nature of your business you say you want to run, the bank consider to give you such a time, 6 months, 1 year, 2 years in some big projects, to say that 2 years don't pay anything. Then from 2 years, from the third year, you can start paying. Why? Because they understand that success takes time. It takes time to build businesses. And so businesses don't just wake up into life overnight. And so wealthy people understand that perfectly. And so anytime they are in their journey, on their journey to wealth, they are aggressively patient. When wealthy people, when they are also persuasion skill that we talk about, in persuasion, they also understand aggressive patience. Many of us want people to do what we want them to join the kind of business that we are prospecting, but we are not patient. The moment they give us a no, 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 then we go and down tools. Ladies and gentlemen, you must learn this skill, aggressive patience. You must understand that success takes time. Any successful people in life will ever tell, when you hear their story, they will tell you how they fail. You heard in that audio that I played to you, said 7-Up. He said he came to discover 7-Up was named 7-Up. 7-Up bottling company was named 7-Up because that was the seventh attempt of the owner of that company in building business. He said it was a 6 down, the 7th time up. He was down 6 times, but he kept on chasing his dream. He was down 6 times, but he never lost hope. He was down 6 times, but he kept on pushing. And at the 7th time, he made a huge success. Ladies and gentlemen, aggressive patience skill is what you must learn. On your journey to wealth, you must be aggressively patient. The fact that you fail today does not mean you should hands down. Many people are not into anything investment today. They are not into anything business today because they failed at one time and they said no. Let me tell you, I keep telling people, one, two businesses in the world today, in the world, no matter what you like or think about them, that can give you massive wealth is Forex and crypto. But ladies and gentlemen, this same man that is saying this today, 2007, I lost huge money to Forex. I lost it the first time, I lost it the second time, I lost it the third time, and again in 2019, when they brought this opportunity, I opened my ears and I listened and I saw the reason why some people fail and some people succeed. And I went out for people, for the kind of company that succeed in Forex and crypto. And today it's a huge success. Success takes time. And if you stick to it, you will get it. Type it in the chat box. If I stick to it, I will get it. If I stick to it, I will get it. The fourth skill that you must have on your journey to wealth, don't forget, keep it in your mind, persuasion skill, energy management skill, aggressive patience skill. And then let me talk to you about recruiting skill. Recruiting skill. If you stick to it, thank you, Yinka. Thank you, Okwe. If you stick to it, you will get it. Let's move on quickly to recruiting skill. Recruiting, wealthy people know that they can never go it alone. Wealthy people understand the power of people of like mind. Wealthy people, like I told you, if you are rich as a one person, if you enter into a community of rich people, you become wealthy. You can be rich as an individual. The same level of riches can make you to be wealthy as a community. So wealthy people understand the power of the people, having people of like mind around them. And so one of the skills that they possess to be able to do that is called recruiting skill. Recruiting skill. You must know how to get people who are good at what you are not good at. You must be able to recruit people who are of like mind with you. You must be able to recruit people who can help you in your journey to achieving what you want to achieve. And wealthy people also understand that if they help others to achieve their goals also will be achieved. Did you hear what I said? Wealthy people understand that if they help others to achieve their goals in life, they also will achieve their goals. And so wealthy people are always about chasing to help others to achieve their goals. And so what do? They find such people that have similar destination with them, and they recruit them into their company. They recruit them into their companionship. They recruit them into their community. Wealthy people understand that if they help others achieve their purpose, they also will achieve theirs. So wealthy people go out recruiting. And that is why today, when you look at the one of the most prospering business that prospers people so massively today is called network marketing. Because wealthy people have come to discover that if they get 10 and 10 gets 10 and 100 gets on 1,000 and 1,000 gets 10,000, then they can build a high capacity team. And so what do? They find the first 10, the first 10 gets the effect, the 100 gets the 1,000, the 1,000 gets the 10,000, the 10,000 gets the 1 million. Power of recruiting. Because let me tell you, no matter how influential they are, I don't know people. I don't know that the people that he knows. So what do? I only know you. I recruit you and give you the assignment to recruit the people you know. Why the people you know, you also give them the assignment to recruit the people you know. So, and what this translates into is that where the people understand how to grow leaders, how to grow leaders. And let me tell you, in recruiting, you must have two things. Don't forget, in every skill, there are values that you must possess. In recruiting skill, in having a recruiting skill, you must have the values of knowledge and integrity again. Look at integrity. That if you look at integrity, you discover that wealthy people have integrity. Wealthy people have integrity. They've gone back 20 times, have never failed the bank returning their money. They've gone to friends 50 times asking them to borrow them, to grant them credit, and they have never failed one time. So integrity is key in your journey to wealth. In recruiting skill, integrity is key also. Knowledge is also key. The two go together in recruiting. Why? Because the knowledge you have about what you want to recruit people into must be solid before you can recruit them into it. I spoke with somebody here today. He came to discuss something else with me. And I started talking out to him about just a few minutes for him to leave. I said something and he said, please tell me about it. I said, I only tell people, I put this up to people who are in my community. He said, tell me, I will join the community. Just tell me what it needs to join the community. And so I told him, and the next thing I showed him, right there and then, I got millions of naira transferred. You know why? Because number one is knowledge. I have the knowledge of what I want to recruit him into. And he also trusts me as a man of integrity. The beginning of the journey of recruiting is being convinced of yourself, being persuaded of yourself, of the purpose for which you are recruiting people into. If you want someone to buy a product, you must know, have detail about that product. If you want someone to begin a journey, to start a journey with you, you must have the full detail of the journey. You can't tell him, when we get to the midway, we will ask. Then he will not follow you because he doesn't want to be stranded midway. So do you know enough about what you are trying to recruit people into? Ladies and gentlemen, if you do not understand this recruiting skill, you struggle alone in life. Let me tell you, there is what we call the power of the multitude. The power of the multitude. What the multitude can achieve for you, you cannot achieve most time. You cannot achieve in 20 years. So you have the multitude, and you have the understanding and the knowledge of what you want, and they trust you. Then you will achieve things with speed. Ladies and gentlemen, if you are still hearing me, I want our chat box to be full today because I'm burning here with fire. So I want people that are catching the fire that I'm burning with. Many wealthy people understand that. And so, like we said in our previous lecture, who are you? Who are you is not asking for your name and Yemi Ayodele. No, sir. When they ask you who are you, they are asking what is your integrity? What is your integrity? Ladies and gentlemen, your integrity is key. in the journey to wealth, in the journey to recruiting, in having recruiting skill, you must have two things, like I said, knowledge and integrity. And this is very, very key. Ladies and gentlemen, let me touch the last one that I want to talk about today. I've been able to do about four or five things or skills, so that maybe next Saturday we'll be able to wrap it up. Next Saturday we'll be able to wrap it up. Don't forget, let me take it over again. We looked at persuasion skill, which we talked about last week. We just did a recap. We look at energy management skill. Then we moved to aggressively patient skill. Then we went to recruiting skill. And I'll now talk about one more before we close today. And it is called money making skill. Money making skills. You will ask me, who cannot make money? Millions cannot make money. More than 95% of people in the world today do not have this skill. Money making skill is not a joke. And money, because money is a byproduct of wealth creation, on your journey to wealth, you must have the money making skill. How much skill do you have about making money? That's why today you see a lot of people, there are cheaper ways to making money, but they prefer the traditional way of making money. There are simpler way of making money, but they prefer the herbalist way of making money. Don't forget, we define traditionalists and herbalists as people who are stuck in their ways. People who have made up their mind that the things that how my father made money is how I want to make money. How my grandfather made money, by going, by having farm, by opening shop, by opening laundry, by having eatery. How the fathers make money is laborious. And you must understand that in this generation, there are simpler ways of making money. So what are we talking about? Money, making money requires skill. Making money requires skills. If you are still talking, hearing me, and you are enjoying what I'm saying, please give me a 12 in the chat box. Give me a 12 in the chat box. If you are angry about what I'm saying, give me a 12-0. But if you are enjoying what I'm saying, give me a 12 in the chat box. You must learn how to make money. And let me tell you, there is no machine that makes money. Ideas make money. Ideas make money. So when we talk about making money, we are saying that you must have idea mindset, a mindset that generates idea. It's ideas that makes money for you. And so you must have a mindset, of an idealistic mind. Yeah, let me use that English. Have an idealistic mindset. Desire ideas. Sit down, brainstorm. Wealthy people brainstorm more than they eat. They brainstorm. They take out time to retreat and brainstorm for the next level that they want to get to. You must have an idealistic mindset. There is no money-making machine anywhere. Thank you. You must have an idealistic mindset. Brainstorming, retreating character. You know when the idea that is working for me today, I need to rejig it. I need to rejig the idea of what makes money for me today. Because let me tell you, don't forget my quote. You can be informed and not be updated. The skills that men of 19th century, 21st century used in making money is no more applicable. It is too laborious for making money today. For example, the 100,000 of 10 years ago is a big money. 1 million of today cannot do what 100,000 can do. So if you are locked in the skill of how they made 100,000 in 20 years ago, you cannot survive this generation. So you must understand how to make money, because money is a byproduct of wealth. idea, an idea is what makes money for you. In today's generation, idea, sharing idea, being in the group, that is what our community is doing. Being in a community where people are coming with ideas daily. I told you, second week of December, I profiled 12 different ideas. People brought it to me. I sat down to brainstorm and to study about it. At the end of the day, I found one or two good. I tested the one on two, and by January, I could recommend them and say, go and do this, go and do this, go and do this. It will bring money for you. Idealistic mindset. Because it's idea that makes money for you. It's idea that produces products and services. It's ideas. It's ideas. What people are benefiting today, somebody brainstormed to come up with it. Ladies and gentlemen, it's important that we understand. And I just remind us again, what are those skills that you need in your journey to wealth? Persuasion skill will require a character of sincerity and integrity. Energy management skill, which makes you to conserve your energy for the 20% activities that give you 80% of your result. Then you must be aggressively patient. You must understand that success takes time. If you stick to it, you will get it. Then recruiting skill. I say also in recruiting skill, two values that are important is knowledge and integrity. What's your name? Who are you? What is your integrity? What are your values? Then I talked about the money making skill. Ladies and gentlemen, if you have enjoyed us today, and tomorrow again, we'll be meeting to share a few products and opportunities that wealthy people take advantage of to enter into their world. But if you want to join the community where we are growing 10,000 by 2025 wealthy people, helping them to grow their wealth from scratch, and you don't mind to embrace the discipline of contributing a minimum of 50% of whatever you earn as you earn it. Ladies and gentlemen, this is where to be. We have seen testimony of members of the community who in the last 2 months have been earning 7 digits every week. We read the testimonial of someone who is earning about 5 digits. He said high 5 digits. High 5 digits means from 60,000 every single week. We saw people who are earning 7 digits every single week for the past 6 weeks. Ladies and gentlemen, what the community helps you to do is to build a culture, a discipline. When you see people around you donating 80%, you will ask yourself, why can't I do 90? Why can't I do 70? You know, ladies and gentlemen, when your budget is 100% spent, I still review several budgets every day, and I see people who have, in fact, they spend all their income and they still have negative. And I say, you can't be in our community, because in our community, before you spend 1 naira, you must first hand over minimum of 50% of your income to the community to help you and show you where to invest it. Ladies and gentlemen, as one member of the community, we'll be dropping the link to the community. In case you have made up your mind to join the community, please let one of the mentees in the community drop the link. Please, until you have made up your mind, until you are sure that you want to be accountable and you are willing to make the sacrifices to the things that we are committed to doing in the community, please don't bother to join. The moment you are sure, please click the 2 links that is in the chat box and be a member of this community. Even though I show you every Sunday opportunities that the world take advantage of, I don't show all. The reason why I also profile the difference, because if you are a member of the community, I do a profiling of you. I know how much risk averse you are. So I know what to suggest to you. I know people that will never forgive me when they lose 1 naira. So I know what to suggest to them. I know people who will say, sir, I don't mind losing 5,000. Just show me the opportunity. I don't mind. And you discover that the things you are afraid of never comes to pass. You know, the things you are afraid of never come to be. So, you know, and that is why I play that audio on risk taking to you at the beginning of this program. If you want to join the train, please click the 2 links up. One is for Telegram group, the Telegram group. One is for the WhatsApp group. Make sure that you click the 2 and join us. But tomorrow, We'll still continue by 2 p.m. showcasing opportunities and products that the wealthy take advantage of to enter into their wealth. If you have enjoyed today's program and you would love to join tomorrow again, or you want to become a member of the community, please, as a way of appreciating all the beautiful things that you have learned today, give a 777 in the chat box, as we used to do in our culture in this community. Give a 777 in the chat box. Thank you for coming here. See you again tomorrow by 2 p.m. My name is still Yemi Ayodele, a financial analyst and investment advisor. Thank you, and see you tomorrow. Bye.